れである本番によこときのはけ
乾杯とかわい、
うん、
Now,
if we listen to that,
that wire that has bored out, the wire that has bored out, halfway, oh, whakapapa, all links. You know, whakapapa doesn't have to be the only word that you use. Here. Time of links, not here. That waiata, Michi, the name waiata whakamana ni te mai.
Aroha mai.
E te waiata pāne ki te whakapapa tai waka. E te tūrongo, mōra mahina nai, e te teia no whakapapa, kia whaki rua, moe kia rua pitahanga, ka pita mai ngā āriki, ngā rangatira, ngā whakapapa, ngā whānu haku iwi. E koina te mahi anō. Ta kuara rā nā tūrongo i wawa e ki te tae rā whiti koma, i nā ki te whare rā i moi. Ai a rau kawa, nā rau kawa kore, re ahu nā re, re ahu koma, koto ki no haku no te pekara i toro mai a, pati hua ue nuku tū whatu, ko tū watangi roa ko ne au paraman, he ara e tau tika mai ana ki a ue. E tūra e tae mā ka hoki mai, aku mā hara ki muri kia whakamā. Rōtia te kā wai momo nui ko pārenga, ope whakahinga mai ki te peka o hikaero. Ko te wāwā hanga kia puta ko te kā hurangi, hei tākihi te kōwhaetanga o te ata o te tangata. Ko te rau anga anga kia puta ko pō tatau ko te kini e tū mai nei i te muri. Whakarongo mai rā e runga e raro katahi nei. Ka tino rite, ka tino pai kia hui a mai te tikanga. Kia horahi a te marino, ka takato i te aio, mō wai roki roki e. E koko ia, e koko ia, e ara e.
Kia ora. Kia ora.
Engari, if you listen to that, if we all listen to that, that's that. What did that song also say? It said exactly what we were talking about before.
Kāhi ariki potatai.
It was really talking about the house, number one, the house of potatai, like as we said, the house of Windsor, similarities, and then number two was talking about the links. Whakapapa. Tribes. So there is that ara. There is that ara. So ara is used a lot.
Okay?
So language is a pathway. You know, you don't see a path called language, right? You in your mind, that's the way you that's the way you communicate your thoughts and your views. Okay? But as I said, have a look at her PhD. It's online. Have a look at it. You'll find it interesting. Right. Here's another metaphor. O te kuini o Ingarangi, he kōtuku rere ngā tahi. The Queen of England, not only her, it's used for a lot of others. The Queen seen someone that's really seen. It applies to something or someone that's really seen. Normally someone. Tētahi tangata, kāre tino ki te ana. Kā kore ki tea, he momo kōtuku tērā. E kore e ki tea. O tahi wā noi hopea i te ao e o rāna te rā tangata. Mandela kōtuku rerenga tahi tērā, te rā tangata. We were lucky, we saw him Tūrangawā, with our kōhanga reo. So got the Queenie Oingan on me, okay? Right. And likened to the white heron.
Right.
Really seen that bird? So that's why I was looking at the environment that we are part of was used by all our tupuna. Nothing was left out. Nothing. Kua whetūrangi tia koutou. You have become stars, right? In the above, with rangi. Kua whetūrangi tia koutou. Koutou, as in those that have passed on. Metaphor. You have become a star. In karanga. Ko takahia mai e koutou te ara o ngā tupuna. You have come via the road traversed by our ancestors. And if we're calling, we're doing our karanga and people that maybe we don't know and normally we like to find out beforehand, you can use these kinds of calls. Haere mai rā koutou, ko takahi mai I te ara mai o koutou tupuna. So that pathway that we don't see but it's in the mind, right, is used again and again. That's a metaphor. Right? In whai kōrero, haere atura I te ara I takahia e rātau maha. Go via the pathway that all our departed loved ones have gone. And that's heard today, all the time, in tangihanga. I roto I ngā tangihanga, I roto I ngā hui. Kei reira ngā wā katoa. Haere I te ara, I te huarahi. I whāia I takahia e o tātai tūpuna. Other things in tangihanga, and you know, you may want to look at that, karakia. Or waiata might be waiata that have those words. Mā hupe mā roimata, kā ea te mate. It is through tears and nose mucus that death is avenged, right? That death is repaid. What for? Why is that? Death has taken. Kua haria e tei o tātou. Death takes. So our reply to that is, in cultural terms, I roto I wā mā tātou tikanga Māori, e ti ana tātou. Mā hupe, mā roimata, ea ai te mate. Through tears and nose mucus is death avenged. Me whakatāpea mo tētahi wā me. Okay, right, so.
Oh, sorry.
Just stop there. Now, anei tō kuao. A rangataua. Anei ngā pāpaka o ngatau, I can't see what I was looking for once, and I've got some pictures, but I couldn't find them. I've got pictures of the titiko, our titiko, and that's a small seashell like a snail, and we pride ourselves, and I remember one of our kuia from Tūranga Wāwai. We went over to one of my relations' wedding, and she said, oh, kwaiana mea kai kona he titiko. Oh, be good if we see the titiko. And we did, because you feed something to iwi that's
significant.
Peculiar. Ki etahi atu Māori, e pāna ki tō rohe, tūrangati rāna te iwi. You feed something that is environmentally only found in your area, that means, hey, you know, your hospitality is of the highest.
Mm-hmm.
In Te Tauranga Nui, probably the Pātiki or the Tuna. Whātā paka, flounder. Tauranga moana, well, I don't know you. Fish, right? All the things from the sea.
Yeah.
Mm. And so that determines your hospitality level. Level. Tū hoi, hea.
He kere rū.
Kere rū. Ai, me au.
Well, hey, no relation to Sunny Town, by the way.
And Ngā Huia, Tauranga Nui, tomorrow is white bait.
Yeah, and white bait, yes. White bait in Te Puaho Waitako, Port Waitako. So here, yes, is the titiko. Now the titiko,
like a pupu. Bigger than me.
Right, here we are. And this is my back. Right, okay. My canoe is Matatua from the dogs. Dogs ngā kuri. And really they're rocks, right? Out in Katikati, Bowen Town. From the dogs of Tikiro. Some of our iwi from Matatua say Tikiro. Cast your eye to Tauranga, there you will find we, the symbolic crabs of Rangatawa. We will greet you. And I said that, so found there. The titiko and the crabs are our write this down, ngā toko o tō mātou mana hapu. Our identity markers. Te mana o Rangatawa.
Where is the photograph taken?
Football, so I don't know
where the crabs go then. Okay. Where is the photograph taken?
Pardon? Where is the beautiful photograph taken? This was taken at our marae. Uh-huh. Our marae is Maunatapu.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you'll be related to my.
And over here is the bridge going across to the mount.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
All right. And right here, about here, missed it out, is a grave, a tomb, and it's one of our ancestors, our tupuna. But there again, I did it for a reason. I didn't take that because I wanted to highlight in its condition three, us putting up stones and all that.
Yeah.
Because then you see the changing nature of how we think. We have, over here we've got this tomb for one of our ancestors. So therefore it shows the changing nature of how we view the world. Through putting up stones, a tomb-like thing for one of our tūpuna that died, and that's on a marae. So obviously that came post-colonial, right? And, you know, not just buried in the ground. So I thought, right, I'll just have this as is. You don't see the bridge, but the bridge is here.
Yes.
That's going across to the mount.
The mount.
Mowal. Right. Now, I thought this is my darling hubby. Right. But I thought I'd also take, these are metaphors as well. Right. Now the photo is Waikato Times, verbal source. Manurani Maya, she's Hawaiian. She taught here for 2 or 3 years ago. And what is he doing? Well, fundraising for Kimiora, basically. Fundraising for Kimiora, where he raised nearly $2,000 rowing from Kirikiri Roa down to Manawahia. But he is shaped by his environment. A Waikato man. I wouldn't put the sea there because he's not from the sea.
Mm-hmm.
He's from Waikato. So, as Manurani said, and as you've all indicated, you're shaped by where you live, by where you come from.
Maramotira? Where you come from determines how you look at the world. Make no bones about that. You all say, oh, I'll go back to, oh, good to be back home, recharge my batteries. That's really saying your world determines how you think. You know, I really always think about the sea. And you know what? We used to have fish heads. We used to live on fish and I'm a sack of fish.
I know the feeling.
Fish again. Fish every day. Seafood every day. And you know, when I left to marry and come inland, I missed food. I missed seafood. So there you are. You miss that.
Connection.
Would you be able to share that metaphor that I always remember it because your daughter shared it about the Waikato River and about getting caught in the weeds and the one that you shared? Your muko's
Waikato.
Yeah, about being in the river and utilising the river as a metaphor about saying stay in the middle, don't get caught in the weeds and dragged along, as in there's a life lesson.
Oh.
I remember your daughter shared it.
If you are on the river or on any waterway, look for the way that is the best way for you, that you think is the best way. You know, it's just common sense.
Yeah.
And so sometimes common sense comes into play. Kauru mai te whakaaro tika, o, e whakaaro ana koe, pai ana te haere, whakamua, kia tai atua koe ki te, ki tāwe he hianga. So you look at the best way forward, so what I said was, yeah, don't go by the sides. And yes, he also said that, kia ora mōtira, don't go by the sides where it's lots of weeds, you could get caught up, and then in terms of that, you could flip over and so forth. Whereas, if you go by the middle, it's clear water. Well, there might be snags there, but there's probably less snags there than there are on the side. Okay. Nō reira ko ngā huarahi e marama ana kia koe. E kite ana koe te huarahi haere whakamua, whaia tērā. The pathway or the way you see that is much clearer. Follow that pathway. But of course we do have people that challenge the environment, that want to do something different, want to climb up mountains or get caught in, you know, nature. I'm an environmentalist. Unfortunately, I don't vote for anybody. But, you know, nature, we can never ever overcome nature. Floods. Now, what do we do as people?
Go
we can
high,
never yeah. overcome nature. You know, nature just seems to rearrange itself. Herself. Notice it's a woman. Herself. Gender. Rearranges herself to
unpredictable.
Suit whatever. That's another thing too about gender, right? In metaphors, in huahuatau. So kia ora mōtira. So pathway forward, look for the best way. Don't go on the muddied sides. Right, I just made up this metaphor because I think it's important. This was taken when we were in Waitangi. When we were Waitangi, I think it was 1994, or may have been a bit later. And that was when some of our women did the karama, and when one of the waka, the new waka, was launched. Kingi Tuheitia's new waka was up there as well. And some of our young men, one of the Raimokopuna was in there, and so one of Atarangi's Mokopuna. And I made up this, you know.